let me just add in Vithi and Vidya. Hello everyone. Thanks for joining. Hi Ramya. Hey, hi.
Hi Nilufar. Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
All fine.
So happy to see you.
I'm happy to see you after so long. I mean, I think last we've seen at each other is at school.
Let's not tell our age, reveal our ages over here.
Seriously.
Let me just add in Vidya.
Yeah, sure.
But really happy to have you with us, Vidhi. I mean, it's like, you know, kind of like a school reunion. Small one.
Yeah, I know. Actually, I got in touch with Vidya few months back only, I think. She needed some exercises for COVID recovered patients. And I just sent her, and that is how we came into contact. And then when I saw you guys doing this, I said, let's take part in it.
Awesome. I'm waiting for Vidya. Let me just send an invite again.
Yeah, sure.
Hi.
Hi, Vidya.
Actually, the request was sent, but it was loading and loading and loading and nothing came out. Yeah. Hello, Vilges. Hi. Yeah, Vidhi, so
hi,
nice
Vidya.
To see you after so many days.
Same here.
Yeah, sorry.
So many years.
Yeah.
There's hello, Vilges. Started. Vidya?
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, like, you know.
All school girls.
Yeah.
Yeah, all school girls.
Yes. Okay, let us start off. We have been delayed a bit. So, Vidya, I'll start by introducing you. Okay. Okay, so Dr. Vidhi is a physiotherapist. She has been practicing from the past 10 years. She has her own private clinic in Kandivali West, Mumbai. She specializes in antenatal and postnatal areas. Over her practice, she has worked with multiple women and she has actually been able to help those women to get back to their pre-pregnancy fitness level. And she has also worked with patients who had urinary problems and diastasis rectus. So she has done a great lot of work. And apart from that, she also is a mother. She had a 5-year-old son. So, and I guess she delivered her baby to C-section. So whatever she has been teaching in her practice, she practiced it herself. All the posture corrections, the exercises, and she right now, if you see her, she is like, you know, just like a super mom. She is like, you know, trekking with her baby boy. She is playing all sorts of sports. So yeah, I mean, that's like, you know, that's a classic example of what you practice, right, Vidhi?
Yeah, right. Thank you, Nilufar, for the introduction.
Yeah, and to start off, I want to start off with a very basic question. Okay, so maybe there are people who are not really aware of the term postnatal. So can you start off by explaining what exactly postnatal physiotherapy?
Yeah, sure. I was just starting on that. See, postnatal physiotherapy is the exercises, the postures, what you maintain and what you do from 1 hour after the delivery to up to 6 to 8 weeks. So basically physiotherapy starts one hour after delivery. Post delivery we start and it goes on up to 6 to 8 weeks. That is your basic physiotherapy. After that is all your weight loss part.
Okay.
So all that we will not take it now. We'll just talk about the first 6 to 8 weeks.
Right.
So now people will ask, like, why should I do physiotherapy postnatally? I mean, our mothers, our grandmothers, they have all been fit. Agreed. I do not disagree with that. But we have a certain aims, like what you can do postnatally, like 1 hour after to 6 to 8 weeks. So our first aim will be the physical aspect. Then the second aim will be the mental aspect. The third aim will be your breast engorgement, your lactation issues and all that. Then your fourth aim will be your posture. Because most of the people do not know a proper posture. You need to actually tell them this is not the correct posture of feeding. This is the correct posture. Because if the posture is not good, then what happens is the mother is also not comfortable. The kid is also not comfortable.
Right.
Correct.
And then the fifth part will be your weight loss journey. So now when we come to the physical aspect, now what physical aspect, what all things we do? One is your diastasis recti. The front wall of the abdomen has a muscle which actually moves apart as your uterus starts growing. Now as the uterus starts growing, it has moved apart. Now it is your duty to get it back. So the toning has to be done. So the toning has to be done. So for that, there are certain types of exercises which you need to do. And the second is your core fitness. A lot of people, they just neglect their core and then they get all these back pains and different type of issues. Basically, they stand for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes and then they say like, oh God, I have started getting backache. They do a little more work from what they are doing and they start developing backache.
Yeah.
So this backache is basically, it starts very slowly, but then it becomes an actual big problem for them. So that has to be taken care. So more of that comes in your core fitness. And the third one is your urinary incontinence. Now for urinary incontinence, now people have accepted the fact that it is a normal postnatal thing which happens.
Yes.
So they are not actually, they don't know it's not a normal phenomenon. It's like abnormal. Okay. You have to go and visit a doctor or you have to go and see a physio. They don't even think about it. So these are the things which we see on the physical aspect. So, and mental aspect will be your depression, anxiety, your overall low mood, what you have post-delivery. So, all that comes into your mental aspect. So, basically, mental aspect, we don't do much. But the, you know, good effects of exercise help to elevate all these.
Yes.
Now, when you exercise, your body releases certain feel-good hormones. We call it in scientific term as endorphins.
Yes.
So, these will help to improve your mood, and when your mood is improved, you are all like, when the mind is well, you are all well, like that.
Then
you have lactation issues. A lot of people have breast engorgement. Now most of them know when the breast engorgement just starts, they don't know what to do. They don't actually don't know. They let it go, it'll go away, they sit. And then it becomes a big abscess, and then you have to go and get it surgically removed. Then you cannot feed your kid, and all that issue starts.
Okay.
So we actually teach them. We teach all this in the antenatal classes itself, so that they know that postnatally all these things can happen. So they can recognize if there is an engorgement early, and they see help early. So that is like
what it
more
what
helpful.
Happens actually.
What happens?
What happens? Yeah.
Breast engorgement is what? The milk starts accumulating. And then it becomes a small abscess, and then the abscess starts growing. So what we do is we give certain types of massages, hot water fomentation and all those things, so that the engorgement, what has happened, reduces. And it reduces. Sometimes it reduces within 2 days, 1 day, 2 days, it reduces. I mean, I myself experienced this, so I know it very well. And those who don't seek help, but trust me, it is very, very painful. An engorged breast is very painful, And especially when you're going to feed your kid, it's very painful. Then you have issues with lactation. Like sometimes what happens, people have flat nipples. So you need to do syringing of the nipples so that the latching is proper. Otherwise, the kid will not latch properly. Then you will say the kid is biting. The baby is biting, and I'm not able to feed. And then they will go for all those top feeds and all that thing.
Yeah.
Baby, it is very important to feed. Not only from the point of view of the baby, but even mother's health is very much important if you feed. So all those comes under the lactation issues. There are other things also in lactation, but we will not go into detail about it. Then comes your posture. Mm-hmm. Then we'll come to the posture. Now, what posture you are taking for lactation? That is very important. Mm-hmm. Because most of the people now I've seen, they bend like this with the baby and then they are feeding.
Yeah.
They are bending because initially now, first 15 days, the baby feeds for a longer time. And the first 15 days are very important because that is the main period when you have back pain.
Okay.
Correct. After that, the back pain reduces. I'm not saying it will go away. It reduces. But the first 15 days, you have so much of pain. You have your episiotomy sutures, or if you have a C-section, you have a C-section sutures. Mm. So that is paining. Yeah. Apart from that, you have a lot of back pain also.
Yeah.
So posture is bad. So what we tell them is use pillows. Use pillows, support yourself properly, support the baby properly. You are comfortable, baby is comfortable. Then let the baby latch. Otherwise, what you are in a hurry.
Yeah.
You are in a hurry. The baby is crying. Okay, come on. Just feed it. Even your elders say, come on, the baby is crying. Just feed that baby.
Yeah, it happens.
I always instruct my patients, keep 3-4 pillows next to you, next to the baby, so that if the baby is crying, you just need to adjust the pillows and start feeding. You are comfortable, baby is comfortable, end of the session. That is very important posture. And one more thing, what happens is because you have been carrying your fetus 9 months in your womb, the spine has, the curve has changed. Because of that, you are having shoulders like this. This is not the posture of the shoulder. So, there are a lot of exercises for shoulder, which is neglected. What people say, okay, I have back pain, I'll do back exercises, I'll do a little abdominal exercises. So that my tummy will go in, my back will be fine. Okay, you corrected the back posture. See, it is a chain. Your shoulder is connected to your spine and your spine is like this. So if one aspect you have corrected, the second aspect you have not corrected, you will not get proper results.
Correct,
So your shoulder is still drooping.
Most of the people
and a drooped shoulder.
Most of the people are more worried about their tummy going in rather than, you know, focusing on the right posture.
Exactly, I agree, totally agree with you. And then see, all those diets come in picture. They are eating all those diets, and then what happens is, because nutrition is not available, you are already feeding, and on top of that nutrition is not available, you are losing everything from your body. And Indian females do not, I'll tell you, Indian females do not take their calcium and iron supplements seriously. I'm eating I forgot. Okay, everything is there. Please, that is just 2 tablets you have to swallow, one in the morning, one in the evening, done. They don't.
It's like you're telling me.
It's like scolding. No,
yeah.
What you are telling me.
Array, but see, I have practiced and I'll tell you, it's a big headache to... asking them to come for the session is a big headache, first thing. Then asking them to pop 2 tablets is a bigger headache.
No, you know, Vidhi, there's one issue with that. Okay, I'm just like, you know, just telling from my personal experience. You know, the elders in the house, they started telling me, like, my baby had a lot of colic issue, or I don't know what, he was just crying. Like, you know, people are under this assumption that taking iron and calcium supplement will actually, harm the baby. Kind of like, you know, your breast milk will not be easily digested by the baby, or something, a fact or a myth or whatever. But then I also had a suggestion, from the elders in the family that you should not be taking all these things. This point.
See, but what the elders... No, it's true. Yeah. What the elders have eaten, I don't think we are just eating 50% of the postnatal diet.
Yes.
Okay. And second thing is, if your baby has an issue, it happens sometimes. Calcium ion tablets can cause gas. Okay. You need to go consult your gynecologist. See, this is the issue. Is it causing the problem to my baby, or is the baby having a genuine other problem? See, a lot of babies have colic. So for right. colic, what we right. ask the parents to do is put them on the tummy, give them tummy time.
Correct.
The more tummy time you give, the colic problems what the kids will have is less. Or else we ask them to take the knees to the chest so that the gas is released. See, there are a lot of postures which release the gas in the mother and in the kid. We do not have in India this culture of antenatal classes and postnatal classes. A lot of knowledge you can just tell. Okay, if you are going to see, you are going to have gas post delivery, you are going to have gas. So what you should do?
Right. Yeah,
post delivery, your baby is going to have gas. What are you going to do? All these answers you should know beforehand, rather than okay, gas ho gaya, ab kya karu?
Right.
You should have these answers, and that is very important. Especially here in Maharashtra, they don't understand the concept of postnatal massages only. I don't know what is wrong with the people here. They're like, kya hai ye massage? there's no concept.
Sorry to interrupt you, Vidhi, but the thing is, after my delivery, right, now I know, okay, how important it is. Whatever you're saying, I should have known it earlier. But after delivery, that's it.
You got it.
No. I mean, at home, not in the hospital. They didn't even tell me what posture, nothing. They told her, feed the baby. What feed the baby? I don't know.
A problem with the first time mothers. I mean, if I had not done studied this, I think I would have been the worst person with this, because I don't know how to hold a baby. I mean, we have held a baby for forever. So it is an issue. Mine, the son was the size of my palm. His head was just this much. It was not only me, even my parents were scared. How are you going to hold the baby? I said, don't worry, it's going to be all right.
Yeah, and you know how tall I am, right? My back was like this only, arched. I was like, how should I? And I had such severe backache after a week. I couldn't tolerate it. I was like, why the hell is my back aching? I didn't know that there are, we should approach. I really was not aware. Even at my home, they didn't know that, we should go and ask. And even in hospitals, they don't tell. You need to talk to a physiotherapist. Other than gynec, there is another duty doctor who came and spoke to me that you need to feed for 2 hours. But how? Nothing was told. But we feel that, they should have a small session of physiotherapy session also. I mean, the physiotherapist can,
I just want to interrupt you guys, okay? We are having a lot of questions, okay? Just giving a hands up. So we have some time spared to answer at least a few of them.
True.
We have a lot of questions, okay? But just to add to your point, Vidya, you said, right, like in your hospital, there was no specialist like that, okay? But the hospital where I...
Right,
came,
yes.
There was a physiotherapist, okay? She came, okay, she taught me some basic... mine was a vegetarian. So she came, I think after 3-4 hours after the delivery, and she taught me some basic exercises. But then again, what Vidhi mentioned, right, that how to feed the baby, that proper posture, those things were not
exactly
fine. Like, this is the first time I'm Vidhi is saying that under physiotherapy, this is also covered. Because for me, it was like physiotherapy means you just have to do some exercises.
Even I was under the same impression.
Yeah. Good info, Vidhi.
Luckily for me, I delivered in SBM, so we had everything. I mean, it was my own college, so I had everything there ready. And I also knew things, so it was easier for me.
Yeah.
We'll just discuss the last part, that is the weight loss. In weight loss if you are feeding your baby, your weight will automatically reduce. Because the fats in your body are... secreted in the milk, and then your baby is getting it. So that is the first step towards weight loss. The second is massages, what we were discussing right now. See, massages not only will tighten your skin or it will improve the muscle tone, but there is one more thing, and that is it will release the feel-good hormones, that is oxytocin. So now what, that also, oxytocin is a hormone which will help in involution process. See, the uterus has come out. Now the uterus goes in also, no, post-delivery. So that takes 6 to 8 weeks.
Right.
Now that when the involution is taking place, massages help a lot in that process. So you actually, you have to go 6 to 8 weeks compulsory massage to karna. Every day you should do, and post that you have to do hot water fomentation. Relax your body as much as you can. Then next will be your healthy diet. Take healthy diet. Go for walks. Short walks you can start. Then the next important thing is tying a belt. Post natal, people in South Indians, they tie a sari. The entire thing.
Yeah,
you get postnatal belts also. And if the midwife is experienced, she'll tie it properly, the sari. Very important. Yeah. It will help. See, it will also help in involution process. Plus, it will support your back. So, the strain you get on your back, no, that will reduce. So, there will be pain reduction will be there. And next, it is supporting your abdomen also. So, the diastasis or the bulging of the abdomen, that will also reduce. So, this is basically an overview. Now, we can take the questions because I don't think we have that much time.
Sure.
I'll just go through the questions.
Then till then, no, we can talk about the exercises also if we have time afterwards.
Just to
definitely we can answer the question.
Just to add to Vidhi's point, Dashi mentioned that you have to take the massages. So girls, out there, massages like actually it's like a spa. So think of getting spa for one and a half months. So plan it. Plan it for yourself.
Yeah, true.
Not doing that.
Are, see, that pampering what you're going to get for 6 to 8 weeks, now after that nobody is going to ask you. I am telling you.
True.
You get 6 to 8 weeks, at least you are resting, you're getting massages, everything. After that, when you go back to your work, and in Indian scenario, forget it. Nobody is talking to you also whether you are well or not well.
Yeah.
They will only see to it that their work is being done or no.
So the first
awesome.
No, Indian culture is very shrewd. The mother-in-law is waiting on the head of the daughter-in-law. You have resting for 2 months now. Seeing to it that the work is being done.
True.
And those who are in the nuclear family will have the burden. Now be 2 months and before that pregnancy period, the husband has worked. Now I have to work and take care of the kid and the house. And if I am a working woman, I have to work also.
So
enjoy it 2 months, then you can do just whatever you want.
Do whatever.
It's
very important point.
Yourself, plan for yourself and enjoy it. Okay, the first question. Okay, so it is from Shruti. My baby had the latch issue, so I'm exclusively pumping and feeding. Is it fine? Everyone says it's not. I am so worried. Kindly suggest.
Hi Shruti. See, this is a very valid question. You have flat nipples, so that is you need to do syringing. I mean, I would ask you to consult your near.
Vidhi, she has not mentioned that. She just mentioned that her baby is having the latch issue. She has not given the underlying cause. What?
Okay. See, 80 to 90% of the time, latching issue is because of the flat nipples. Sometimes, the posture is not proper, or there are other issues also. See, best would be talking to a lactation consultant right now, because online I cannot tell you anything. If it is flat nipple, you can try syringing.
No, but maybe Shruti, you can approach Vidhi personally, and then maybe you should be able to guide her.
Can do that. And see, pumping and feeding is, there is no issue. A lot of working women, they pump their milk and feed. There is no issue. But see, ask the kid to latch and feel, because that will improve its neonatal reflexes. See, there are a lot of reflexes when the kids are born, and some reflexes will carry on with the life, but some reflexes have to go away. So a lot of learning happens when the baby is latching and feeding.
Okay.
There are a lot of neonatal reflexes which develop with the kid when they are latching and feeding. So I would tell avoid pumping, but if it is not avoidable, you cannot do anything, pump and feed. There is no issue. There will be no problem.
Yes.
But at least try to feed the kid. That is what I'm saying. And if it is a flat nipple issue, you can try syringing. It will 100% work.
Yeah, so Shruti, definitely there's no issue in pumping and feeding. Okay, you can, I mean, that is also something, you know, a good thing, the best thing that you can do for your pump and feed. Okay, everyone says it's not, I don't know why people are saying it's not. Okay, it is good, but then yeah, as suggested by Dr. Vidhi, the best is to have the baby latched on to you directly. So maybe you can consult with her itself and like, you know, get some solution for that. But then again, like pumping and feeding, if at all she's not at all able to feed, then I think pumping and feeding will not have an issue, right?
Well, then, yeah, because see, it is the breast milk which is going, at least she is not giving the milk powders and all those things.
Yes. Okay, there's one
you
question.
You can take the next question.
Okay, so I don't know, like, you know, what we can reply for that. So this is from Ashita. It's a very vague question, so I'm just skipping that off. Ashita, maybe you can connect with us offline and we can, like, you know, discuss further on what exactly the specific issue you are facing. So if it's your second baby, I don't know what exactly is your issue. You can connect with us later. Okay, there are so many comments, like, you know, so cute and all. So thank you for that.
Yes.
Thank you for those comments. Able to pull out any other comments? Like, one, comments are like, you know, some like cheering comments kind of things. So thank you everyone.
Okay. Thank you for cheering us.
Yeah.
So many are like, you know, the cheering comments. And Ashita, please do connect with us later so we can figure out what exact issue you're facing. Okay, because from your current comment, we are not able to understand. Yeah, so there's another comment from Pavitra. She's saying that latching would help in emotional development and attachment as well. So
Niloufar, I couldn't get you, your voice was cracking.
Yeah, so there's another comment. Okay, I mean, it's not for answering, it's more like, you know, Pavitra is saying that latching would also help in emotional development and attachment of the baby.
Yeah, very true, very true, very true. Especially when the baby is feeding, now you just look at the baby's eyes. It is always watching the mother. What is the mother doing?
Yeah.
Just look into the eyes of the baby. There will be an emotional connect and baby will feel more towards you. See, initially what? No, the baby just smells. Yeah. It gets the mother's smell and baby recognizes the mother that way.
Yes.
So it will definitely help with emotional connect.
Yeah, so there's, so Shruti saying thank you, you're welcome, Shruti. And Meenu has a question, but she just said that she has a question, so I don't know what is the question. So Meenu, you can type the question.
Meanwhile, I just want to tell, so as Dr. Vidhi said, it's very important for the postnatal therapy, okay, physiotherapy is really important. We might not know the importance, so all you get is the 2 months. After that, nobody is going to pamper you, even if you ask. So please enjoy the 2 months or 3 months if you're lucky, if you get 3 months. And very important points you said, Vidhi, regarding, you know, postures. How we can correct, there are some towns where physiotherapist is not available or postnatal physiotherapy is not available. So that time what they can do, what a woman can do?
See, you can just start with your shoulder stretching, front muscles of the shoulder. You can start with the shoulder stretching, keep your posture. You should be conscious about your posture. Pull your shoulders behind. Push the wall. Like, you can push the wall so these muscles will get stretched. And your back muscles will get strengthened. You can start doing that before also, like around from 4th month of your pregnancy. So that you are maintaining a proper posture. Once you have attitude of a proper posture, then postnatally there will be lesser instance of you going for a droop posture. And when you're feeding, use a pillow behind to support your back. The best posture to feed is sit on a chair with the back support. Keep a pillow on your lap, then the baby, so that the baby comes to your breast and you are not going down to give the breast. Okay. And then support your baby, support your baby's head with your hands. Keep your hands rested on the chair. The handrest is there to keep your head hand rested on that chair. And get the baby to your breast. You don't bend down. If you are tall, use two pillows on your lap.
Yeah.
Sit on a chair. And if it is not possible for you to hang your legs for that long, keep the legs straight on the bed. Sit on the chair and put the legs on the bed. That will be a very good posture. You are relaxed. Baby is relaxed. Everything is fine. There will be no back issues later on.
Okay.
We have a question from Minu. Okay. So she's asking about breast sagging and posture post-feeding.
Yeah, see, breast sagging will happen because, see, over the months you have gained weight. You have gained weight everywhere, but the breast and the abdomen and your thigh region is the main reason. So now when you are losing weight, things are going to get sagged. So for that, no, you need to do a lot of exercising. You need to do a lot of massaging.
Okay.
So massaging and exercise, both of them will surely help. It will not be like previous, like pre-pregnancy, this thing, it will not be. But it is still there so that it is not sagging. Basically, it is not sagging. If you do the exercises, then you have proper support bras for sagging. Use those. Those are very important. Use them well. Because there are some cultures in India only, there are some cultures who tell the new mother not to wear bra. I said, please don't do that. Wear.
Okay.
You can hear me, Nilufa?
It's a lag actually.
It's loading.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
We can hear.
We can hear you.
The video.
I'll just answer this. I don't know whether you. They say not to wear bras, but I still say wear bras. There are special bras for feeding. Wear them, and afterwards you have sagging bras too. You can use them. And with your exercises, massaging, and proper posture and bras, you can definitely avoid sagging.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Right.
We have lost with his video completely. Maybe there's some issue with her Wi-Fi.
She's back.
Yeah. Anyways, we are done with our session, right, Vidya?
Yeah.
So I just want to tell one thing that Vidhi mentioned, okay, and I think it's really important that Dr. Vidhi mentioned.
Nilufa, I can hear you. Only thing is, videos I am not able to get. I don't know, there's some network issue. Actually, it's been raining here for so long.
Yeah, you can complete, Dr. Vidhi, whatever you wanted to tell.
Yeah, there's some issue.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. But there's
okay, is there any more any question?
Yeah, there's one more question, Vidhi, but what we can do is, if you're able to hear us, it's well and good. Otherwise, like, you know, we'll connect with you offline. There's another question. Okay, I think this is from Pooja.
I can hear you, Nilufa. I can hear you. Only the video feed has gone. I think there's a weak network here because of the rain.
No issues. I'll just read out the question to you, Vidhi, then. Okay, so the question is, breast size is too small. Breast size is too small. Is there any way to increase it, due to which I feel milk quantity is less? This is a very
important
question.
Yeah, a lot of mothers do. See, milk supply is a demand and supply issue. If you're going to feed, keep feeding it. Keep feeding your kid. The demand, if the kid is demanding more, definitely your body will supply more. Apart from that, gynecs do give a lot of supplements like Shatavari powder, and there are some tablets. You can take them, but with consultation from your gynecologist. That I hope before you could hear the answer.
Yeah, we were able to hear you. It was a little bit distorted, so I'm just going to repeat your answer to Pooja. So Pooja, actually, size does not really matter a lot, because if your baby is needing more milk, your body will produce it, so your baby will not shortfall, like it will not fall short of milk. Okay, so like, you know, you can you know, you don't have to really worry about your breast being small, so you cannot really provide the proper breast milk. So that will be taken care of. But then, as Dr. Vidhi suggested, if you still have some doubt, you can always approach your doctor before taking any other supplements. So there are a lot of supplements available, like Shatavari powder. And I just missed what Dr. Vidhi said, the last thing. But then, yeah, there are some supplements available. You can do that. But then, you know, don't assume that because of the breast size, your milk supply is going to be affected. So, yeah, I think
that's right.
Okay. Vidya, I think.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, we can conclude the session.
Because Vidhi, if at all we are having any questions, we can reply.
I can hear you. Only thing is the video has gone, so I think the network is weak here. I can hear you.
Okay.
No, I don't. I'm not finding any more questions as well. Okay.
Questions.
Yeah, if at all I'll find something, we can take it offline, Vidhi.
Okay.
Yeah, and thank you so much, Dr. Vidhi, for joining us. It was a lovely session. We felt it so good after, it was like a school reunion, mini, micro maybe.
Yeah, true, Vidya, very true. It was like a reunion.
Yeah.
I mean, there was so much matter to talk about. I thought, I don't know whether we'll be able to finish or not. This network issue has stopped us in between.
Yeah, we can have another session. That's not a problem. We can have another session so that we can tell things in detail. And yeah, we can do that. And we can even ask them for, you know, questions. If they have any questions, they can post, send it to us, and we can cover those as well in the next session.
Yes.
Yeah. I cannot hear you.
So, let's wrap it up. Thank you everyone who have joined us and who will be watching us later. Thank you so much. And thank you, Dr.